Now joined by the generalsports.com athlete of the week, Nick Spagnoletti. Nick, coming off a big week, back-to-back games with 20-plus saves in each of them. What are you seeing net the last few games?
Yeah, so, I mean, ultimately, last two opponents have been CNU and Roanoke, and, you know, came into those games knowing they had some great offenses with some great shooters, so knew that I would have to bring my A game to both games. But, you know, I think really the main thing has been just the defense in front of me and how phenomenal they've been playing this season. Ultimately, when everyone's buying in, doing their jobs, buying into the plans that Coach Mendoza's set down for us every game, you know, it makes my job that much easier, makes it that much easier for me to see the ball and ultimately make those saves that I've been making.
Saturday's game, an 11-8 win over Roanoke. You guys stay unbeaten in ODAC play. Just what was the big key to Saturday's win?
Yeah, so obviously huge rivalry game, one we're always excited about, one they're always excited about. We knew they would come in hungry and that, you know, they would bring a ton of energy, and ultimately we needed to match that, especially on a day where, you know, the weather presented some challenges. You know, I thought we came in and did come in with a huge amount of energy. You know, ultimately I thought we had a great defensive game plan going in, able to hold them to single digits on the day. And, you know, I think at half, Coach McCabe made some great adjustments and, you know, offense came out firing right off the bat. I'll shout out Ty McCowitt with a huge career day with 5 points, and, you know, Matt Gallagher and the rest of our face-off personnel really held it down at the X. So, you know, I think complete game from everybody, and we got the result that we wanted.
For more of a personal level for you, this year you've really gotten the chance to start full-time, and you've relished that opportunity. What's kind of, you know, been the biggest key for you to getting back to starting on a routine basis and realizing, hey, this is my opportunity to really make an impact for this team?
Of course. Yeah, I mean, it's been surreal this year. Obviously, something that I've always dreamed about since being a kid was just being able to start for a great college program. But, you know, I think that, you know, everything that I've done up to this point has just really prepared me well for this opportunity. I think back to the goalie rooms that I've had on our team since my freshman year, being able to learn under guys like Jack Taylor, like Matt Lanigan, like Will Atkins, like Aiden Long. I can't really thank those guys enough for, you know, really preparing me for the spot that I've been able to be put in. And, you know, finally just stepping in behind a veteran defense, you know, led by guys like Michael Horgan, Teddy Bentley, you know, just makes my job that much easier when I can just put my sheer faith and trust into the guys who are playing in front of me.
Now this weekend, you guys go on the road to Lynchburg, a really interesting game against a nationally ranked opponent. Could be, you know, big implications come the postseason and everything. What's going to be the biggest key for you guys to walk away with a win on Saturday?
Yeah, you know, it's you know, obviously an exciting game, big rivalry, storied rivalry. It's going to be an extra challenge having to go to their place, playing under the lights there and the atmosphere that they'll be creating. But, you know, ultimately we'll hit the chalkboard this week, prep like we always do, and, you know, hopefully come into this weekend and get the result we want.
Nick, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.